Hello, everybody. I'm Xavier. Welcome back to another episode. Sorry I'm jumping off sporadically out of the blue. I'm not watching the time, and I'm trying not to have these huge segments. I mean, I'm pushing 50 minutes almost these past three segments, and I guess that's all right, but I don't want to go overboard with it, so here we are. Another episode. Continuing the saga. We're on at the MoonPools. To go. There we go. Got all of our lead. Is there a door I had to cut in here, or are we good? Huh. Yes, I know. Are you really gonna graze my house? What are you gonna do when I put a moon pool right there, huh? Huh? Watch where you're going, you drunk. Captain. If I time this right, I should be able to do this before my battery power cell dies on the CMOS. So scared. What is that? Oh, I already have that. I always get that confused with the thing that upgrades your vehicles. That's right, turn around and go the other way. Stop by later, we'll have dinner. I hope that's right. Don't you dare. He's gonna get in my way. that's done. Get some glass so I can create an alien containment thing so I can get my two Reginalds out of my bag. Any quartz in here? Where did I put it all? Thought I had some. Shame on me.
captain.
Now, multiply. Let's go with, yeah. More quartz. I'm not used to having moon pools.
Are you tired of drinking the same old gas station coffee? You want a damn good cup of coffee? Maybe check out some nice artwork in the meantime. Then you should check out Under the Black. Under the Black is a locally owned and operated coffee shop and consignment art dealer based out of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. We use the finest beans available to create our signature coffee blends directly from our kitchen to your door. Swing by our site and check out not only our coffees, but also our products and consignment art. Promise you won't be disappointed. Check us out at the site below.
Get off my CMOS. Now. Now. I swear I'm not drinking. Just coffee. That should do it for what I need now. Let's double check. Yep, we're good. Now I'll grab these two. Will you please stop doing that, Dopey? Welcome aboard. I don't know why I'm doing this. It's... Once again, I'm not used to having a moon pools. I also don't have my glass set up on my, my base, so... So I can't see. those lights are gonna blow my freaking energy out. Progress. I love progress. In regards to the base building, anyway.
30 seconds.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
One more. My face. Don't do it. Don't do it.
Welcome aboard, Captain. Welcome aboard, Captain.
Thank you. 2, 3, 4. 5, 6. And however many that's going to be. I need 22 more quarts. Jeez. Forgot how much of a pain in the butt this was.
For cave divers is loss of orientation. Be advised, a common complication for cave divers is loss of orientation, followed by the ritualistic initiation.
Hit it in the kelp. Didn't go near the cloud. Quartz over here. I pay for putting lights in a bit too early. Here we go. I think with the power going out, I'm kind of being told something. Like maybe I should go get Ruby, stop messing around. So I can build thermals. When it comes to energy, it has to be within a certain order. Otherwise, you're gonna blow your energy source that's in front of it. Like, for example, it's okay to put down, what is it called? Solar panels. But then, you gotta have something behind it that's gonna be an unlimited source, which is why I put thermal first. As long as there's heat, there will always be energy. Then I pump that up with a bioreactor directly after the thermal, because Reginalds are freaking awesome. And then you top it off with a nuclear reactor, so that way you pump up the amount of energy on your base. I see how it is. Goes all the way across because of reasons. Doesn't help that I have the sea moth planted in there. I think that's going to be it for today. Yeah. We'll deal with the power problem when I come back. So until next time, I'm Xavier. Take care, everybody.